In this lesson, we will discuss how to analyze pressure forces on a control volume. When analyzing pressure forces on a control volume, there are two approximations that can greatly simplify the analysis. The first approximation involves free jets, which are streams of fluid that are exposed to the atmosphere. Here we have a nozzle connected to the end of a pipe, and a free jet exits the nozzle into the atmosphere. Since the free jet experiences atmospheric pressure, the pressure at the outlet of the nozzle is atmospheric as well. So the first approximation is that any outlet that emits a free jet will experience atmospheric pressure at the exit. Let's draw a control surface surrounding the nozzle, and let's say a pressure gauge located at the entrance of the nozzle, which is at the left side of the control volume, states that the absolute pressure is 3 times the atmospheric pressure. To complete the picture, we draw the atmospheric pressure forces surrounding the rest of the control volume. The pressure forces could be analyzed using the picture shown here, but notice that the pressure force on the bottom of the control volume cancels out the pressure force at the top of the control volume. Additionally, some of the pressure force on the left side of the control volume is canceled by the pressure force on the right side of the control volume. We could draw an equivalent picture showing the net pressure forces on the control volume. We would obtain the same picture if we had examined the gauge pressure forces on the control volume. So the second approximation is that you can usually use the gauge pressures when examining pressure forces on a control volume because atmospheric pressures cancel out in all directions. It is important to remember that pressure forces always point inward on the control surface, regardless of flow direction. Here we have isolated a pipe bend, which is part of a large pipe network. The top and bottom sides of the bend are exposed to the atmosphere, while the inlet and outlet are connected to pipes. Flow enters through inlet 1 and exits through outlet 2. We now draw a control surface around the pipe bend and identify the pressure forces on a free body diagram. Since atmospheric pressure forces cancel in all directions, we can use gauge pressure when determining the pressure forces on the control volume. The pressure force on the top and bottom sides of the bend are 0 since it is exposed to the atmosphere. The only pressure forces we need to consider are at the inlet and outlet. The pressure force can be calculated by multiplying the local gauge pressure times the cross-sectional area. The pressure force at the inlet is P1 times A1, while the pressure force at the outlet is P2 A2. Both P1 and P2 are gauge pressures. Notice that the force vectors point inward at both the inlet and outlet, even though the flow direction is outward at the outlet.